there's this idea. I remember when I first read Richard Foster's book, Celebration of Discipline, and I really read it, and not that Foster would recommend this at all, but I got so excited because I thought I was going to get something, some great spiritual euphoric feeling out of practicing these things. And in fact, when I fasted, I was just simply hungry, you know?
Yeah, fasting doesn't feel good.
And irritated, you know, and these kinds of things.
It's totally misnamed, right? Like, we ought to call it slowing. I mean, fasting just it's misnamed. Yeah. Makes you crabby and not effective. The other fast, non-food fast, that has been really revealing for me is to periodically fast from communication technology. And I do this with students. I ask my students, in the Divinity School where I teach, to for 1 week not use cell phones, not use email, not do Twitter, not get on Facebook.
When we think of the term spiritual disciplines or spiritual practices, we think of at 6 o'clock tonight, I'm going to get on my knees and do this thing. And you're opening it up beyond that definition.
Well, in Judaism, there are these two basic principles for Sabbath keeping. The positive principle to do things that are joyful and the so-called negative commandment to not work.
Repeat that, because that's an important thing that I don't want to just slide over. The idea of doing something enjoyable on the Sabbath.
Doing things that are joyful.
Not just to stop doing what you're doing. Where would somebody who really has never had a concept, and this has been their introduction to those ideas, where do they begin? What do they do tomorrow? What do they do next week as a sort of first step to practicing a spiritual discipline?
Well, I think what they do next week is have a conversation with people who know them, and the conversation starts with, what are the spiritual practices already in my life that I don't even notice or name that way? Again, just I think discernment begins with description. So what's already happening? Like, where God is already inviting us, and most of us are already showing up haltingly, occasionally. You know, sometimes we're showing up. So where do I seem to be drawn to show up for God, and how can I show up more?
That's a fascinating first step. I mean, literally sit down and describe what is already happening in your life, the spiritual disciplines that you're already performing that you may not know about, which would take some introspection. And then to go through a menu of prayer, fasting, confession, keeping a Sabbath, and just go, what do I want to add? What is the palette from which I want to paint in terms of spiritual practices? Let's see.